Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll be discussing one typical bit difficult question of marginal costing, where we are required to find out break-even point in units and rupees where variable cost details are not clearly given. Let us read this question. A company sells its product at rupees 15 per unit. Selling price is given rupees 15 per unit. In a period, we'll refer to this as first period. It produces and sells 8,000 units and it makes loss of rupees 5 per unit. If the volume is raised to 20,000 units, that means if units produced and sold are increased from 8,000 units to 20,000 units, it will make profit of rupees 4 per unit. So here they have given the details of units produced and sold, and they have given the information about the selling price. They have not given any information of variable cost and fixed cost. Further, they are asking us to find out, calculate break-even point for in rupees as well as in units. This is the information we have. Now with this, we are required to find out variable cost, then contribution, then PV ratio, and then we can find out the actual answer for break-even point. How to do this? Let us start. In first period, there is output of 8,000 units, and in second period, there is output of 20,000 units here. Sale price in first period is 15 rupees, and even in second period it will be 15 rupees. They have said that if you produce and sell 8,000 units, you are going to make a loss of rupees 5. Here we can read that information. 8,000 units, if they produce, there will be loss of rupees 5. If they produce and sell 20,000 units, there will be profit of rupees 4 per unit. So we'll put that value of profit or loss. Selling price 15, loss is rupees 5. Selling price 15, in second period there is a profit of rupees 4. So in first period, after adjusting that loss, 15 plus 5, total cost we get 20 rupees. In second period, selling price is 15 and there is profit of 4 rupees. That means cost we are getting 11 rupees. This is per unit cost in both the periods. Based on this, we can find out the total cost. So we have reached up to total cost of first period and total cost of the second period. Total cost of the first period is 1,60,000 and total cost of second period is 2,20,000. If we observe this carefully, the amount of fixed cost for both the period would have been the same. So we will try to find out that what is the difference of cost in relation to units produced. So in first period, units are 8,000. In second period, units are 20,000. So difference is 12,000. We can see the difference in cost. It is 2,20,000 minus 1,60,000. So it will be 60,000. This is the difference of total cost we are getting. So during the period, if the units produced goes up by 12,000 units, the total cost is going up by 60,000 units. Based on this, we can find out variable cost per unit. To get variable cost per unit, what we are required to do is, this 60,000 we are required to divide it by 12,000. That is difference in total rupees divided by difference in units. 60,000 divided by 12,000, we get answer. So we have reached up to the variable cost per unit of this particular production. It is rupees 5 per unit. Our task will be to find out now the amount of fixed cost. During first period, we have produced 8,000 units. So we'll try to calculate variable cost for the first period. The formula is total variable cost will be equal to units produced multiplied by per unit variable cost. In first period, there is produced and sold units 8000 multiplied by, just now we have calculated variable cost per unit is rupees 5. So 8000 multiplied by 5. Variable cost will be rupees 40,000. Now we'll try to find out the fixed cost. Previous working total cost for the period is 1,60,000. From this we are required to deduct variable cost to arrive at the figure of fixed cost. Fixed cost is equal to total cost minus variable cost. So total cost we got 1,60,000 minus total cost 1,60,000 minus variable cost 40,000. So here we got fixed cost 1,20,000. We can verify this for the second period. During second period, there is total cost 2,20,000 minus variable cost. In second period, we are required to produce 20,000 units multiplied by 5 rupees per unit variable cost. So 2,20,000 minus 1 lakh. So total cost 2,20,000. Total variable cost 1 lakh. 2,20,000 minus 1 lakh. Answer is 1,20,000. So fixed cost we got same in both the case. It is 1,20,000. So we have obtained the information of fixed cost. As per the question, they are asking us to find out break-even point amount, that is in rupees as well as in units. We'll try to find out the amount of PV ratio. For PV ratio, we are required to have the information of contribution. Contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. Here selling price they have given in the question rupees 15. Variable cost we have calculated with working note rupees 5. So amount of contribution per unit we got 10 rupees. Now we'll proceed to calculate PV ratio. Formula is contribution upon sales multiplied by 100. Contribution is 5 rupees. Selling price is 15 rupees multiplied by 100. It comes to 33.333%. So this is almost 1/3 of sales. That is profit volume ratio we got here, 33.33%. Let us proceed to calculate break-even point. To calculate break-even point sale in rupees or in amount, we are required to use formula. Fixed cost divided by profit volume ratio. Fixed cost we have calculated. Our fixed cost is rupees 1,20,000. Fixed cost 1,20,000 divided by PVR, we have 33.33% over here. So approximately we are getting the amount 40,000. So break even point sale in rupees we obtain rupees 40,000. We are also required to calculate break even point in units. To calculate break-even point in units, our formula is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. We have already calculated fixed cost 1,20,000 and contribution per unit we have calculated rupees 10 per unit. 1,20,000 divided by 10. So it is 12,000 units. So we calculated break-even point in units, 12,000 units. So in this question, we had only information of units sold and selling price. We have information of profit and loss. Based on this, we have calculated variable cost, fixed cost, and PVR. And then finally, we have arrived at break-even point. Thanks for watching this video. Stay in tune with Ikeda and subscribe to our channel Ikeda.